Championship Wrestling from Florida. I'm Gordon Soley, your host. Buddy Colt has joined me, and of course, we've got an outstanding hour in store for everybody today.
Boy, I'll tell you, do we ever. You know, I think today will probably even surpass the great wrestling program we had here last week. We have Mike Rotunda wrestling here today, who is hot on the trails of the Florida Heavyweight Champion and also World Champion Ric Flair. Also, Barry Windham will be wrestling today, Big Ed Gantner, and one of the great matches lined up for the last match today is a tag team match pitting superstar Bill Dundee along with the Barbarian going up against Big Scott Hall and Stan Lane.
Promised to be a lot of excitement. We'll also be talking to our good friend Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, a little bit later on. Right now, though, I would like to welcome to the program Mr. JJ Dillon, the administrator of the Four Horsemen, and of course, associate also Lex Luger. Tully Blanchard is also with us, and Arn Anderson. JJ, welcome aboard.
You know, Gordon, you stated last week, proof is in the pudding right here. When I decided to expand nationally, my first decision was to go to the NWA, Crockett Promotions, the top wrestling in the world today. My next decision was, who do I associate myself with? Who do I befriend? Right here, I did my research. Where I've gotten today is because I researched every move I make carefully. And what happened was, there's a group, my accountants, my fans, there's a group here that makes more money. They're the top draws of any wrestlers, and that's the Inner Circle, the Four Horsemen. They dress in style, they travel in style, we flew in here in our private jet. That's the kind of lifestyle I wanted, that's why I wrestle, and the group's right here.
What it all amounts to, Lex, what you're trying to say is when you work for the finest promotional outfit on the face of God's earth, I'm talking about Jim Crockett Promotions, and you are one of the Four Horsemen, the two go hand in hand. You look at Tully Blanchard, tailored clothes. You look at Ric Flair, tailored clothes. James J. Dillon, tailored clothes. Well, it takes more than clothes to make a man, you see. While most individuals get up in the morning, have a little French toast, and crawl on the couch, we're in the gym training. I'm talking early morning hours. We're doing the squats. We're doing the step-ups. We do what it takes to be the elite. See, you don't buy a silk jacket and put Horsemen on the back of it. Horsemen is 24 hours a day. Yeah. It's a way of life. It's a lifestyle. So, gentlemen, when we walk in a bar or a restaurant or a clothing store and your girlfriend or wife suddenly has a short attention span, don't take it personally. It's just because she saw a little more than she wanted out of life, and I'm talking about the Four Horsemen.
You know, Arn, you said all that, and it is all that. It is a lifestyle. But in professional wrestling, if you don't have one of these, you're not anything. And the Four Horsemen can brag of the world's television champion. That's me, Tully Blanchard, Ric Flair, the world's heavyweight champion, and the soon-to-be United States heavyweight champion, and our associate, Lex Luger, stepping up in class and style. And I'll tell you what, Florida has finally made itself
in here, Lex.
Professional wrestling again, Four Horsemen.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. You've heard from him, the Four Horsemen. A power to be reckoned with, certainly no question about that. We'll be back with a special videotape message from world champion Ric Flair.
The name's Ric Flair. I represent the National Wrestling Alliance, the greatest wrestling governing body in the world today. I'm talking about big-time professional wrestling at its best. And that's what brings to mind championship wrestling from Florida. I'm talking about Gordon Soley. I'm talking about Coach Heath. I'm talking about the legendary Eddie Graham. I'm talking about his boy Mike. I'm talking about Dusty Rhodes, Barry Windham, Mike Rotunda, Scott Hall, Kevin Sullivan. I'm talking about all the great athletes that compete for championship wrestling from Florida. And then let's talk about Ric Flair, old Slick Rick himself. Space Mountain to a lot of the ladies, the living legend. The man that makes professional wrestling what it is today. Because whether you like it or not out there, the bottom line is I'm the best in my sport. I'm the best there is. I make the most money. I wrestle the most times. I make the most appearances around the country. I'm all over the world. You know why? Because every promoter in the country wants to say he's got Ric Flair's name on the marquee. That puts people in buildings, and that's why I'm back in Florida. So whether you like it or not, I'm going to say it one more time. Windham, if you're man enough, you shut my mouth. Rotundo, if you're man enough and you don't like what I got to say, you shut my mouth. Scott Hall, you punk kid, I'll slap you across the face. and run you out of Florida just like that. And then Dusty Rhodes, you've made the claim. You've told them all. You're back in Florida to take this from me. Well, Big Dust, I've said it before, I'll say it one more time. Diamonds are forever, and so is Ric Flair. Woo!
NWA World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair has just spoken, and now we're getting set to watch Mike Rotunda of Syracuse University going up against Sean Royal. Rotunda in the black trunks, seeking that Florida Heavyweight Championship. He is an outstanding competitor. He is a strict adherent to the scientific style of wrestling. However, if you decide you want to go to Fifth City, he's ready.
Well, there's Sean Royal very closely watching Mike Rotunda. Mike Rotunda, of course, being a real wrestling machine. But I tell you, if you lower your guard for just one moment against a man like Mike Rotunda, you can find your shoulders down there for a 1-2-3.
No question about it. Nice fireman carry takedown just a moment ago. Side headlock, and Sean Royal fires him off. It's Rotunda up and over his man. Sean Royal caught him coming in, full body slam. And now it's Royal trying to come down across the chest. Rotunda very alertly brought those knees up, caught Royal in the pit of the stomach. Now a forearm to the side of the jaw. Irish whip reversal now by and Rotunda. Cross body block, almost had the pinfall on the Sean Royal. Irish whip, another reversal. And this time it was Rotunda with a forearm into the side of the jaw that rocked Royal back. Has him up. Airplane spin brings him back to the canvas. Hooked that far leg. Underhooked the far arm. Had the man down for the pinning combination. So Mike Rotunda made short work of Sean Royal. Let's see if I can get Mike over here for just a moment or two. Certainly a real pleasure to see this young fellow back in Florida once again. He said he's a former All-American out of Syracuse. All-around sportsman. Mike, congratulations, a fine victory.
Tomorrow night's a big night, Gordon. I've been looking forward to this a long, long time. We're going to have a chance to go at it, Big Ed. So you get ready. In Daytona tomorrow night, we're going to see who the real Florida heavyweight champion is.
Fair enough. Mike Rotunda looking for that Florida title. Obviously, that would be a stepping stone to a match with Ric Flair, the world champion. We'll be back right after we take this timeout. Well, it's almost Thunderdome time, and the principal in that is Kevin Sullivan.
It has come down to one day in my life. You see, men are challenged many times, and cowards die many times, but the brave man dies but once. Bad news, Alan, you are a brave man to come into Thunderdome against me. You see, I know my very essence is going to be sucked to the final limit. You see, two men enter, one man leaves. This means bad news, Alan. At the end of this match, one of us will be no more. You see, I saw a real strange thing, too, in the record-breaking crowd in Orlando. Just like in my heart last week, I realized that Big Bubba was an errand boy. You see, I saw you talking to the American Dream himself. He has aligned himself with you. He has pleaded with you. He has given you inside tips, Bad News Allen. You have practiced your kung fu, your karate all week. He wants you to end this thing because when he came back to the homecoming, if you will, the gathering, I felt something that I have never felt for a long time. And it went from him to you, and the energy was joined with the American Dream and Bad News Allen. But I'm telling you this, Bad News Allen, everybody seems to align themselves with Dusty Rhodes. You see, now Mr. Soli has aligned himself with you. They're whining and dining. Well, Mr. Soli, what do you have to say about that?
Well, all I can say is, as a matter of fact, I did have lunch the other day with Bad News Allen, and we do have a videotape of it that I think you ought to watch very, very carefully because it certainly concerns you. The conversation starts off, we're talking about Sir Oliver Humperdink. Let's go to that luncheon date, shall we?
And where I come from and the way I was raised, you don't have to sit down and sign a contract with a man. You take a man for his word, you know. And he looks you in the eye and he makes a promise, and you make a promise, and you go out there and you do your best. And then to have him to renege on the promise, which is, to me, you couldn't get no lower than that, you know?
Actually, it was even more than reneging.
Right.
It was an insulting gesture, in my opinion.
Yeah, exactly. That's what it actually boiled down to. It was a slap in the face. That's what it came out to.
$1,000. So that's what I'm prepared to do right now. Kevin Sullivan, you've been my good friend for a long time. It's good to have you back. No contract between us. We're good friends. But here's your part of the money, brother. Here's your $24,500. And Bad News Allen, thank you very much for your services. There's $500 for you.
Hey, you know what? His tech gave with $500. They go crazy. You know,
you get out of Main Street down to Bexley.
Don't spend it all in one place.
Kareem Muhammad is doing at ringside there.
Coming out here and shooting your big mouth off and telling everybody what a spineless cockroach I am. I paid you $500 for a job you didn't even do. I took you out of the ghetto, brother. And
who the hell you think you're trying to do, huh? Who the hell are you?
They have lacerated the head of Bad News Allen.
You know, one of the most important things, I think, is a man's word and his name, you know. And when you get a reputation that you cannot be trusted, I think you have nothing to look forward to in life, you know.
And then he dragged me into that situation. But
yes.
He gave me that additional money.
Well, then again, that was just another slap in the face, really, you know.
Bad news, we don't have a whole heck of a lot of time here, but Sir Oliver Humperdink wanted you to have this envelope. He said that should be full restitution.
Well, I'd just like to say one thing, Gordon. I don't like the man, I don't trust him, but I have the scrapbooks. I'm in this for the bank book. If he's willing to give me restitution here, then, because I have to agree with him on one thing, somebody is definitely going to get hurt with the situation here. Let me see what we got here. The man did it again to me. He did it again to me. What is this, the new math? This is not even close to what he owes me. But I tell you one thing, I'm going to take it out on his hide right now.
Uh-oh. Well, it certainly isn't $12,500, I can tell that right now. But he's, headed out on the ring. There goes the Bad News Allen. Bad News Allen headed for the ring, and he's caught very quickly by Kevin Sullivan coming in, but we've got a pair sixer going. A real pair sixer going now.
Not too terribly long ago, of course, that you had a chance to wreak some sort of revenge on Kevin Sullivan during a television match that ended up off in the doggone street.
Kevin Sullivan and Bad News Allen. And the fury of this battle goes on and on and on. As you can see, Kevin Sullivan smashed into that police car outside and stuff.
Let me ask you another question regarding this entire situation and the Florida Heavyweight Championship. That had to be the bitterest blow of all when you stepped into the ring with this 270-pound Sir Oliver Humperdink, who's anything but an athlete.
Exactly.
And then to have the indignity happen to you that did happen.
Thank you.
obviously. The thing that you're looking for now is Kevin Sullivan. He's been right. the bane of your existence. Quite possibly, you'll be able to settle that issue once and for all at the Thunderdome.
Yeah, I think this is important. He's been a thorn in my spine, you know, and I'm looking forward now to this Thunderdome for people that probably don't understand what's going to happen. Is that both of us are going to be put into a cage-type ring, but it's going to have a top over it. It's going to have a dome-type top over it. And there's not going to be no referees. Two men going to walk in there, and only one's going to walk out.
Tomorrow night, Bad News Allen, we're going to find out if you're the jester for the king or the king himself, because remember, to be a king, you have to kill a king.
Let's go to the ring. We have a tag team matchup coming now. Lex Luger and Arn Anderson moving out against the Sterling brothers. One fall, 10-minute time limit, waiting for the bell to ring. There's the bell. See Tully Blanchard and JJ Dillon at ringside with Anderson and Luger. And it's Arn Anderson in the red trunks moving out very swiftly against Mr. Sterling and catching him in those ropes. And that's the thing about Arn Anderson. He'll let out all stops in order to win a match.
Give the Sterling brothers a lot of credit for getting in the ring, but apparently they made one big mistake, and that mistake was getting in the ring against men like Arn Anderson and Lex Luger. And with J.J. Dillon there at ringside, Tully Blanchard there at ringside, the Horsemen are, the combination of the Horsemen is just fantastic. It's one, some of the toughest combination in the world, and with these two men in the ring now, the Sterling brothers are going to get annihilated from what I see right now. They don't stand a chance.
They're merciless competitors, no question about it. You notice they're keeping Sterling tied up over in their corner. Flip off the rope. Ooh, caught him right at the belt line. Sterling should get over and tag up. He's got some serious problems now.
Well, you know, I can tell that Arn Anderson is taking great pride in inflicting pain and punishment on the Sterling brothers there. And a good drop toe. This shows that this man is a very good classic wrestler on top of being vicious.
Well, the ultimate insult there is rubbing his face in the mat, and Mr. Dillon has certainly administrated well, may I say.
Well, I think one thing needs to be noted, Buddy and Gordon. You know, the American Dream caused the greatest traffic jam in the history of Orlando, Florida, 1 week ago for his triumphant return. And I guess you have to give credit where credit's due, but the Four Horsemen were also there that night. From the response of the fans we've received so far, I think part of that credit has to go to the fact the Nature Boy Ric Flair has announced his soon return to the state of Florida, and the Four Horsemen are definitely here in grand style.
Well, they're certainly here. Nobody can deny that right now. The Sterling brothers in a lot of problems, and Arn Anderson taking everything that Sterling can dish out and retaliates one to the top of the head that puts Sterling up into the ropes once again.
Well, the Sterling brother there was giving his best shots up right upside the head of Arn Anderson. Arn Anderson barely flinching. This attests to the fact that this man is double tough. The man that's really tough is the man that can take the punishment as well as dish it out. And all of the Four Horsemen are definitely double tough. Right now, it's just showing the contempt for the Sterling brothers. This is unnecessary. It has nothing to do with professional wrestling. They're just showing their distemp for the Sterling brothers.
Obvious that the Four Horsemen like get into this crowd circle with him. Beautifully executed, in a sense, a belly-to-belly power slam. Perfectly executed. And so, Lex Luger and Arn Anderson, in the company of J.J. Dillon and Tully Blanchard, are the victors over the Sterling brothers. It's a real pleasure to have the Florida State Tag Team Wrestling Champions with us right now, the Southern Boys, Tracy Smothers and Steve Armstrong, and gentlemen, so far, so good.
Yeah, that's right. You know, we got the Mod Squad coming up right there tomorrow night in Thunderdome right there at Daytona Beach. We don't know that much about them, but we know that they are seeded number 9 in the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup, Gordon, so that tells you they gotta be tough. Guys, we know you're from the Badlands of New Orleans, but you ain't in New Orleans right now. You're in the heart of Dixie. You're right here in the state of Florida, and the Southern Boys, we're making it our home. We're fired up when we're ready.
Tell us, right there at Thunderdome, probably the wildest event that me and Tracy have ever been in for sure. So y'all come on down. All you good old boys, come on down. Get your four-wheel drives. Throw your pit bulls in the back. Get your Copenhagen, all that good stuff. Come on down and support the Southern Boys. We're going to get some Mod Squad. They're tough. We know it. We got to prove ourselves. We're going to do it, brother.
That's right, Gordon. After it's over, you know, we'd like to invite all our rowdy friends over for a party tonight.
That's right. All right. Fair enough, gentlemen. Thank you so very much. Steve Armstrong and Tracy Smothers, the Florida State Tag Team Champions. We've got an outstanding matchup coming in the ring, so let's go to the squared circle. Bad news, Allen caught from behind by Chris Champion. Right on the bell, and Allen taken off guard, no question about it. And Chris Champion has been pounding away. Now rips at the eyes and continues a flurry of blows into the chest. Now drives a knee into the midsection, and Bad News Allen has taken it all.
Well, obviously, Chris Champion felt the best offense would be a quick attack on Bad News Allen. But I'll tell you, Bad News Allen, he is the ultimate warrior. He has said many months ago that he is the ultimate warrior. This man well-versed in karate, jiu-jitsu, judo, professional wrestling, boxing, street fighting. And I think he wants to make short work of Chris Champion, because tomorrow night will be one of the biggest tests of his wrestling career in the Thunderdome.
Certainly no question about it. Bad News Allen catching him with a headbutt, drops Champion back to the canvas once again. Bad News Allen. He has won numerous medals in judo. Outstanding professional wrestler. Spent a good deal of his career throughout the Far East. I'm referring, of course, to Japan, Singapore, Malaysia. Little body slam by Allen once again on Chris Champion. Allen now crashing down across the pectoralis majors of Champion. Brings him up before the three. Brought him up before the three count. So Bad News Allen, I would imagine, is superimposing the face of Kevin Sullivan on the face of Chris Champion and punishing him in the manner in which he wishes to.
Well, I'll tell you, Chris Champion is one heck of a wrestler. Just recently, having a partner, Sean Royal, with the former tag team champions. But now, Bad News Allen, this could be it.
Little running power slam by Bad News Allen, and let's see if I can get him over here for just a moment or two. Because, of course, he is going to be facing the ultimate test of his career when he faces...
No mercy, Sullivan! No mercy! It's come down to one match and one match only. You won't be able to climb out, and nobody will be able to climb in. That means only one thing. Two men in, only one man is going to leave. No mercy!
And no referee in the ring either, I might point out. It will be the Thunderdome in Daytona Beach at the Ocean Center. We'll be back.
As the Wizard has told us, the one in the black robe, March 15th, Daytona Beach, Thunderdome. Two men enter, one man leaves. Two men enter, one man leaves. Two men enter, one man leaves. Two men enter, one man leaves.
The Florida heavyweight wrestling champion, Ed the Bull Gantner, and his manager, Sir Oliver Humperdink.
Wait a minute now, wait a minute. Nobody said that I wasn't the Florida heavyweight champion anymore. The belt is just here with Big Ed for safekeeping. Because now you see everybody's coming to the state of Florida, yelling for the number one man, and that's yours truly. But I know with the belt on Big Ed Gantner here, that it's going to be a tough role for anybody to hold, including you, you punk Mike Rotunda. I'm talking right at you. You made yourself clear. You come to the state of Florida for one thing. Well, brother, if you think it's going to be a day at the beach or a Sunday school picnic, forget it. Because there's a man right here you're going to have to beat for it. And I don't think you're man enough to do it. Because you're nothing more than a punk from Syracuse, New York. And I rule Florida and everybody knows it. Now, the big contest coming to an end tomorrow night, the dream date with Big Ed. The one lucky girl's going to be selected right there in the Ocean Center tomorrow night, and she's going to have the date of a lifetime, Daddy-O, and I get more requests every week. Please let us see another moment with Big Ed. Well, here it is, just for you. All
right! You know something? You pencil neck punks, about the only thing you've ever curled out there is maybe a 12-ounce beer can. But as myself and Kareem Muhammad back there and Harry know, there's nothing more exhilarating than to feel a cold steel and that blood pump through your arms. Nothing more exhilarating, nothing more satisfying than feeling that blood flow, baby. Almost nothing. Yeah.
Gantner now in the ring. He's the Florida State heavyweight champion, as we said. He's in the red trunks, moving out against Bob Cook. One fall, 10-minute time limit. And, brother, no one can deny the power and the prowess of this man, Big Ed. He is dangerous with a capital D.
Well, I think Bob Cook is very well finding out right now just how dangerous Big Ed Gantner really is. The man is a powerful weightlifter, a powerful wrestler. He was a great football player. He's an all-around athlete. The man, when he goes in the ring, he gets your attention. He gets it fast, as Bob Cook is finding out right now. And being under the management of Sir Oliver Humperdink is definitely in his favor, as Sir Oliver Humperdink can get him the right match. Well, holding him high overhead there, that shows, that attests to the power of Big Ed Gantner.
Interesting comments by Sir Oliver Humperdink regarding that Florida championship. And, of course, the wrestling world was shocked, I'd say even horrified. Sir Oliver Humperdink got the belt. Of course, we saw on television earlier a situation with Bad News Allen, exactly how that occurred. And Gantner not allowing the pinfall here. Cook has taken a lot of punishment. Cook, with an outstanding amateur background, and has been a pretty doggone professional. But he is facing unusually heavy firepower here in the form of Ed the Bull Gantner.
You know, Gordon, Sir Oliver Humperdink getting that Florida title, regardless of the way he got it, is the most disgraceful thing that has ever happened to professional wrestling. And so I was really glad in a way that he gave it to Ed the Bull Gantner just to get it off of that fat frog's waist. Right now, it looks like Ed the Bull is trying very hard or very easily to make an example of Bob Cook. Just like he doesn't want to stop. He wants to really cripple this man.
Well, a high vertical suplex spelled the end for Bob Cook, and so Ed the Bull Gantner. Oh, come on. Wait a minute. Come on, there's no need for this. There's no need for this punishment being meted out now on Bob Cook now with both Sir Oliver Humperdink and... hold on! Mike Rotunda just drop-kicked both Sir Oliver Humperdink and Big Ed the Bull Gantner, and he grabbed the belt. And I don't think they want any part of Mike Rotunda as long as he's got that belt in his hand. That is for sure. Mike Rotunda has cleared the ring. We'll be back in a moment. Well, in just a moment, we're going to be seeing Barry Windham in action. But before we do, I'll tell you what. The American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, is joining us, and what a homecoming you had in Orlando.
Gordon, it was aesthetic. A few points need to be made by Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, Thunderdome. As of March, Bad News Allen, the devil himself, understands now that Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, is back. Also, the police department strung out for miles and miles. Orlando was just the beginning of Dusty Rhodes' return, funky like a monkey tour 1987. Buddy Colt sees the great talent of Mike Rotunda after the World Heavyweight title. Sees Scott Hall after the World Heavyweight title. The great All-American Ron Simmons. Superstar Bill Dundee. Now Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. Throughout the state of Florida, returning, if you will, as Sullivan so plainly said it, a gathering, if you will. Now, dear, it's been made. It's going to happen. And Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, has no equal. Ric Flair came out here a while ago, Garden, and he said, Scott Hall, slap
me in the face if you can take it from me. He said, well, slap me in the face if you can take it from me. On July the 14th, agreeing the ball, I must have slapped him in the face. For the third time, Dusty Rhodes became World Heavyweight Champion. So gather up the family, get all the children out, bring your blankets, and like the Southern boys say, them trucks, your snuff, and your old ladies. Because the American dream, gun sole, buddy coat, and championship wrestling from Florida is definitely back on the air.
Okay, thank you so very much. The American dream, Dusty Rhodes. This fellow has more charisma in his little finger than most people have, I think, in their entire bodies. Let's go to the ring. Barry Windham, who is co-holder of the U.S. Tag Team Championship, along with the man with the hands of stone, Ronnie Garvin. And Barry, of course, a second-generation wrestler going out against Chick Donovan. One fall, 10 minutes, they lock up collar and elbow, and a quick spin under takedown by Windham. Donovan, the golden boy, is a double-tough competitor. His grandfather, by the way, was a lightweight boxing champion. Quick hip lock takedown and into a head scissors by Barry Windham, and it was Donovan breaking loose.
Well, there's been a lot of action in the ring for this first minute or so. Nice drop toe hold, trying for a headlock, but Barry Windham reversed it into a hammerlock on Chick Donovan. Chick Donovan, of course, has a lot of years' experience on Barry Windham. Barry Windham, on the other hand, has a lot of speed, youth, and I'll tell you, a lot of intestinal fortitude. Raised with a wrestling family, his father, Blackjack Mulligan, he was wrestling at the time he was knee-high to his daddy. Right now, Barry, of course, like Gordon said, is one half the U.S. Tag Team Champions. You know, I think a guy like Ed Gantner is in trouble with men like Barry Windham, Ron Simmons, Mike Rotunda after that Florida heavyweight title. Barry Windham keeping a close watch on Chick Donovan. Chick Donovan, of course, at many times being a very, very dangerous man. Knowing all the truth. Nice back to play there on the part of Barry Windham.
Belly to back to play, and it was Chick Donovan, his face contorting in pain as he catches another good solid forearm into the side of the jaw. Irish whip into the bow. Brother, did he catch him with that drop kick? And he knocked him into the next area code, I'll tell you that. He has got some problems now. Donovan in a lot of trouble. Barry, of course, his younger brother, former Florida heavyweight champion, Kendall Windham, still on the injury list. And I saw him come in with Barry. Perhaps we'll get a chance to have a word or two with him. The forearm put him down. Buddy Gold has gone to ringside. And I see Kendall Windham coming out now to congratulate his brother Barry. So, Buddy, why don't you take it away?
Kendall. Hello, Kendall. Good to see you back here with us. You know, after you suffered this injury, you broke a broken leg there at the hands of Ed the Bull, and now I know it's great to have Barry Windham back here with us.
No business in here. Mike Rotunda and the punk. Who do you think the anybody was going to then come on TV and embarrass a bull? What's this pencil neck punk doing out here on my TV?
Well, wait a minute. You're not scheduled for an interview. Well, wait, hey, just a minute here. Now, something's going to... I can't believe what this man, he still has a broken leg. We'll be right back after this.
U.S. Heavyweight Wrestling Champion Nikita Koloff in the ring now, going up against Jack Towers. One fall. Television time remaining, and it's Koloff very quickly forcing his man into the ring ropes, drives a knee to the midsection. Irish whip off ropes, caught in the back of the elbow. Talk about a big, powerful, impressive man. He is indeed.
Well, I'll tell you, he is definitely impressive. Big clothesline across the upper chest and throat of Jack Towers. It looks like it could be all over for Jack Towers. What a last 45 seconds, and the victor, the U.S. heavyweight champion.
Certainly no question about this man's capabilities. He just absolutely overwhelmed Jack Towers in that match. And I'm sure we'll be seeing a lot more of Mr. Koloff in the days to come. But we have a very special feature we'd like to bring you right now. One of the most charismatic wrestlers I've ever known. This fellow is a real fan favorite. Let's go to this video special now. I'm the Boogie Woogie Man himself, Jimmy Valiant. Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Valiant now an Australian tag team, Matt Stanley and Scott Hall, going up against the Barbarian and superstar Bill Dundee. Waiting now for that bell to ring. This match will be one fall, television time remaining, and of course they're removing the collar from around the Barbarian, so it'll be Stan Lane facing the Barbarian first. Lane in the blue trunks. Good wing over. Lane stalking his man. Dundee, of course, is a constant threat both in and out of the ring. No question about that. Off the ropes, and the Barbarian missed with that move, but Stan Lane didn't as he caught him in the midsection. Stan Lane catches him now, a good forearm into the side of the jaw. Referee Jimmy Jett trying to stave off any possible. And the crowd picking up the chant now, go Stan, go. They are solidly behind Scott Hall and Stan Lane. Now the Barbarian, a series of forearms across the back of Stan Lane. Irish have caught him with that size 14. And Lane is outside in Dundee very quickly after him. Aha! It was Dundee as Lane managed to reverse that situation. Big Scott Hall and the Barbarian battling it out in the center of the ring as Stan Lane and Bill Dundee battle it out outside the ring. A four-way melee going here. Barbarian catches Lane from behind, and it is Bill Dundee moving back into the ring, and Big Scott Hall catches him. Dundee has been lacerated across the forehead. Stan Lane in trouble. Scott Hall misses. Stan Lane just hurtled over that barrier that you saw. And now it's Scott Hall delivering one to the midsection of Bill Dundee. Caught from behind as the Barbarian caught up with him from outside the ring. And the referee, Jimmy Jett, having his hands full here.
Well, I'll tell you, this match here has completely lost all resemblance of a professional wrestling match. It's just a brawl right now. And I'll tell you, that Barbarian is just what the word implies. He is barbaric. He's close to 300 pounds, solid muscle, and superstar Bill Dundee. Yes, there. Well, looks like he's trying. Well, big clothesline coming down off that top turnbuckle. It's doubtful of that.
Putting the boots to the Barbarian. And this battle is raging in and out of the ring at this time. Scott Hall being double teamed now. Here comes Stan Lane. Puts him up. And it was Scott Hall into that barrier. And we've still got a wild four-way situation here. And it is Scott Hall who the barrier is completely down now. And it is the Barbarian smashing Scott Hall across the top of the head. That chair, Stan Lane catches Dundee and now begins to pound away on him in the center of the ring. And Scott Hall picks up a steel chair and catches the Barbarian. The Barbarian driven backwards. And everybody has been lacerated. And it is Jimmy Jett, absolutely powerless at this point to stop this situation. And now senior referee Bill Alfonso moves there. He is hurdled to one side by Scott Hall. And these men, wow, did you see him boot him all the way into the face? Well, our time is gone till next week. So long.